victorious members are standing by.
Thank you so much, guys. We're joined here by Xpeke and Mithy to form a Spanish Belgo desk.
Yes. Exactly. Okay. Let's actually talk about the game real quickly here. And I just wanted to talk to you guys about the draft. We saw you guys come out with what's very meta composition compared to yesterday, where some people raised some questions about the draft and you typically went in a different direction. And Elements, they played a typical Elements composition. Did you guys expect that?
Yeah, I think we did. It was especially like the comp. Well, not the AD maybe. Kog'Maw is always weird to see, but everything else was kind of like, yeah, we thought they could pick this. Yeah, we thought they could pick this, but there were not the best picks we were expecting for a team comp, yeah.
I kind of didn't really pay too much attention to drafting this week, or yeah, so I just wanted to play Thresh pretty much.
You could say that kind of showed yesterday, but this one we really wanted to play Thresh. Xpeke, you going for Varus once again. Last week, I think after your game, you tweeted, are you ready to see some more poke in the mid lane? You've been through a meta or two, three. What do you think of this one? How does it suit you?
Well, it's the most boring one. All I do is wave clear for 30 minutes, then I have the most damage somehow done in the team. And I don't even know how, like, I was 0-1-0. And I was dealing like half HP of the squeezes with Qs, and well, it's fun because I don't have to do much, but at the same time, it's boring. I liked it more when I could kill people and play Leblanced and everything like that.
At least there was some action in the start of the game, mostly in the bot lane though, and we have a replay of that. We can get that on your screen right now, and don't necessarily want to talk through, but I just wanted to highlight how, and if we can roll the clip right now, Mithy, it seems that you and Niels, you guys have a good synergy so far, and we saw multiple times in the game you had, you know, that aggressive Lantern. And here, just that play, it just seems that everything's working out for you guys.
I hit a pretty good hook, and from there on, we just know we have to all in. I actually didn't expect so much damage. Niels was forced to flash.
Yep, but what I like the most is the fact that he actually uses, you know, he gets in with the Lantern, then goes out with the Valkyrie, so calculated plays. And it seems like you guys, we're just outsmarting Elements' bot lane.
Yeah, we have played Thresh a lot, and we. You know, every time there's like a 2v2 where I hit a hook, oh, it was like he flashes in, then my Lantern is there for no reason, you know, and so now he knows that whenever I hit a hook and I go in and he's like pushed back, I will Lantern him back in.
And
so
then even, he has
if,
flash. Yeah,
even
yeah.
if the guy flashes out, like sometimes we don't even need to use flash to kill.
Because even later in the game, I think you guys chased down JWoww, and I was looking at the screen, I was like, why the hell is Mithy flashing forward here? And then I saw the Lantern, then Niels procs like Triforce, then another flash, and eventually you guys got him down, so it seems. You guys are on the same page when it comes to engaging.
Yeah, I mean, that was not so good to do. I think it was unnecessary, but I thought that we would kill him without Niels having to burn his flash, so it was my bad.
Yeah, we might almost forget that Niels is a rookie in the LCS, totally coming into you guys' lineup. Yesterday, he had the unfortunate incident with Baron. How has it been working with them and the communication around that? Do you guys then hold his hand and say, Niels, don't do that again, or how does that work?
What incident around Baron?
Kind of went full vein spotting and doubled it.
Oh,
but the game was kind of lost already at that point.
Yeah, it was lost, but it's not like he doesn't have any problems from being rookie or anything. It's just like the Bane pick didn't fit that much with our team comp or against that team comp yesterday. So it's easier once the game is over. But after the game, we were like, yeah, you cannot do anything with Bane because how is he going to get to hit anyone with that frontline they had with Thormails and so much tankiness? He can never get to the squeezes. So if he wants to get to the squeezes, he has to do Bane spotting pretty much. So, which is what he tried when he saw the game was over. He's like, I'm going to try to do something. And yeah.
So yesterday, you guys had, in my opinion, a bit of issues when it came to shot calling and playing to your strengths. Obviously hard with that composition. This game, it was a lot cleaner, a lot crisper, and you definitely embraced the metagame. Who's doing the shot calling in the early game and the mid game? Is it Mithy? Because everybody assumes it is, but is that true?
I think it's everyone. Sometimes I have a good game, so I talk more. Another time, someone else will have a good game and they will talk more. So I think it's kind of that. But yeah. Usually it's mostly me and Amazing talking, but that doesn't mean that the other people don't talk at all.
Yeah.
All right, well, finally, you guys are up against Fnatic for the rematch of Fnatic OG next week. Last time around, you had no losses under your belt going into that one. How do you feel geared up for that matchup in this instance? Okay.
Well, the good thing about it is that eventually they have to lose one game. So if they don't lose any game until that game, we have a really, really high chance of winning just by the numbers.
How does that work? How do the numbers work like that?
That everything has to lose at some point.
Nice math.
So that's fast pace.
So the less they lose, the more they can lose the game.
How about you, Mithy?
I don't see my chances too high, but I would really like to go and shake hands with them instead of them having to shake hands with us.
Yeah. All right. Well, hey, the numbers say you're going to win. There's nothing to argue with that. Congratulations, guys. Thank you guys very much. Now, after the break, it is time for the H2K versus the Unicorns of Love and our final match of the week. Don't go anywhere. There's more European LCS right after this.
Nice stuff.
Elements taking on Origin. As Dexter and JWoww are in retreat, Parallel Convergence comes down. That's going to stun Dexter. The burnout is coming down.
Cogmon on flash. Cogmon on flash.
Lando pull. Lando pull.
Get the cog. Get the cog. Okay, careful.
Zondag now. Zondag now. Zondag now.
I'm soon there.
Blood.
Yeah, he has no pool. I'm coming. I'm ghosting him.
Good job. Careful, that Pokemon passive.
Take a look at Nip in the middle of the team. He's going to be in the next to fall. Death Sentence connects once more from Miffy. I can aimbot this game. Origin with a dominant victory over Elements.